They could have been,
somebody could have said, hey man, just like happened before, Chase said, oh, my shop got broken into, I can't finish your jobs, I got thousands of dollars to get out. It could have been, hey Joe, I'm coming over, I'm almost there. He had five calls, 8:39, hey, I'm here, I'll meet you at the bank or whatever. My brother was going to give him money again. Who knows? It could have been that. That's a possibility too. But I can tell you one thing. They got pulled away from the house by somebody that was comfortable to them.
Mm-hmm.
Because
there was no struggle.
Yeah, no struggle. How did it? Okay. Now somebody seen the vehicle leave that night. I don't know who. Now that's what detectives.
Do you know what they look like?
The lady.
No.
Well, the lady two doors down, three doors down maybe, she said she called the detective and told him that she remembered that she had seen a big truck, white truck, pull up here.
A white truck.
Yeah, big
Chase white. Chase has a white truck with a gray truck. It's an old SBC truck.
There you go.
It's a Chevy 2500 with a box truck on back.
She said that she called the detective and she said she remembers.
How long ago did she call the detective?
I don't know.
Well, which door is it? Let's go knock on her door. I'll go talk to her right now.
She's got some.
Well, we can write it and bring it back over.
I'll bring it to you if you'll just hang tight.
All right.
They're right on the back corner of my business.
So, Mike, just go over this with me first quickly. So, the lady that lives here, do you believe that she saw a white truck?
Listen.
Don't say anything else about it.
I don't know.
Okay.
I'm just, you know what? I'm a concerned brother, and I'm just doing everything I can. And I'm not slinging any mud. I'm just doing my own thing. So, possibly. Okay. And if so, I'll pass along to the detectives and let them do their job.